So welcome friends, in today's podcast we are going to have a new success story with us, Mr. Satyaranjan Mahapatra, who is already qualified NIPER 2020 with All India rank of 8. So that is a very good thing guys, and I think definitely will be helpful for you. So I would like to warm welcome Mr. Satyaranjan Mahapatra on the behalf of Fundamental Pharmacy. Welcome Satyaranjan, welcome to our today's podcast.
Thank you sir. Thank you.
So Satyaranjan, we are very fortunate to have a student like you, because we know that our pharmacy profession is in very stagnant period, and we need a very good students who can take a pharmacy profession in the next level. So a student like you is the correct. Satyaranjan, will you please introduce yourself?
I must thank to Fundamental Pharmacy Tips and specifically Sachin sir. I am Satyaranjan Mahapatra. I completed my B.Pharm from College of Pharmaceutical Sciences, Puri, in the year 2019, and I appeared for the GPAT examination in 2019, but I could not able to clear the paper in 2019.
No, Satyaranjan, please just tell your name, college name, GPAT 2020 rank, NIPER 2020 rank. That will be okay.
I am Satyaranjan Mahapatra. I completed my B.Pharm from College of Pharmaceutical Sciences in 2019, and my GPAT rank was 485 in 2020, and NIPER rank was 8 in 2020.
Congratulations to you. You got a very good NIPER rank in 2020, and you got admitted to Mohali, I think. You are doing sutics over there, right?
Sir, I was admitted in NIPER Mohali under MS Pharmaceutical.
Yes, yes. So, Satyaranjan, will you please tell our student so that they will get idea how to prepare for GPAT and NIPER. So please tell to our student how you have started your preparation for GPAT as well as NIPER. आपने आपका GPAT का preparation कैसे चालू किया था और आपके mind में क्या था उस time पे कि GPAT करना है आपको, क्या कैसे आपका strategy क्या था और आपने कैसे start किया preparation?
So for me during my B.Pharm period, I don't have such idea for GPAT and NIPER. I initially, at last the period of third year, I think for the job also at that time also. But initially what happened, after during my fourth year, I just during second year last or third year first maybe, I was in only one to two groups of pharma groups, and I regularly updated all the questions, and just simple read their things, and not more focus on the GPAT or what to do. But I just think for that I have to go for the jobs. But after that, I feel that in last year that I have to pursue the higher study. So I again, during when 8th semester, I think for that 7th semester last or 8th, I have to appear for the GPAT, because I was not surely that I have to give the paper or not. So that was in like mistakenly, I must say that I choose after that during that time I could not able to clear. So after that even I am in confusion whether to go for job or higher study like MS or M.Pharm, whatever. I think that it is better, always better to go for higher studies. So I took a decision in simply in random manner, like to go for M.Pharm. So I have time at that time because I was passed out from the college, so it is hardly left for 6 months to prepare for the GPAT, and so I take decision after that I have to go for higher studies. So I came in contact with sir since third year, and I was in the group at that time. Fundamental Pharmacy, a lot of groups was there, and MCQs are posted on regular basis. So I just read that things, and at that time one books was launched by sir, and apart from that I also during my B.Pharm I read some of the textbooks, like specifically I read the KTP Party and the Lakpan mostly, and other books like Brahmankar I read the most these things. And after that B.Pharm I was not a studious guy during my period of time, and so I got a chance to improve myself, and in the period of 6 months, so I tried to learn lot of things in that time, because no work pressure on me, nothing on me, no burden was there. I started my preparations I was from the ground zero able to start. So it was from the starting, it was very difficult. Yes.
Because so you, I don't know. You was decided, you was determined, your focus was clear, your target was there.
Yes,
so
sir.
Determination is very important. So you must be determined first. Whatever you want, आपके सामने अगर आपका टारगेट है, determination है, तो ही आप उसके उस टारगेट की तरफ बढ़ सकते हो, कुछ ना कुछ वहाँ पे स्टेप्स ले सकते हो. अगर आपके पास टारगेट ही नहीं तो आप कैसे लेंगे? कैसे प्रिपरेशन किया कि मतलब मेजर सब्जेक्ट के ऊपर ज़्यादा फोकस किया या फिर बेसिक के ऊपर ज़्यादा फोकस किया कि आपने बेसिक क्लियर किया उसके बाद में जो अप्लाइड सब्जेक्ट उसे उसके ऊपर फोकस किया तो मैं तो कैसे मैनेज किया?
Yes, sir, I'm just wanting to point out on this. Like after initially whatever I did, I took the firstly I divided the time frame into 3 zones, like 2 to 3 months, like because that time it was in January. So I decided first to 2 to 3 months I have to brush up my basics. 2 months I completely thorough that. Even and after that 2 months, like this is the first two months strategy. And after that 2 to 3 months I make some again that I have to go for the difficulties areas. Like for me it was medicinal chemistry and organic chemistry areas. I thoroughly read that things and analysis also and other parts also as well because I could not read that thing in much detail manner in the B-Pharm. So in second part I also do that for 4 months. This was my 4 months period and in between that I was actively in WhatsApp groups and giving that some kind of taste whatever is available to me at that time. So it boosts some confidence along with it because instead of getting low score also it gives some kind of confidence to go score in it. And after the last 2 to 3 months I remember that that was very helpful for me and because syllabus is very fast I think that whatever I did I forget all things. So my at that time I called to sir and sir suggested me best tricks. So I want to reveal that tricks today. So sir told me that you have to either go to by 2 ways, either from MCQ you come to the direct books or books to the MCQ. Means whether if you are practicing questions, do in very detailed way and from that questions you analysis and return to the books and it last 2 to 3 months that it is very helpful for me because I practice lot of questions and from each questions I analyze very deeper way and it take times also but it gives you very clarity in concepts as well as in theory also and in one questions you will get 3 to 4 ideas but it is time taking but definitely I will suggest that it will be all to juniors those who are facing like the difficulties in their papers like they didn't manage time in short period of time they are too think for it and it is a good strategy and it works for me.
Okay, Sitaranjan, please tell us, our student, how you manage your semester study as well as your GPAT study because a lot of students have doubts in their mind how to manage the semester study as well as your GPAT study because they used to think that GPAT is totally different from semester. So is that a such or how to manage GPAT study with semester study?
So for my cases it is quite different. Like after that, after pass out, I able to clear the GPAT. But I think that I have also very less time to because I as like a beginner, my mind state was there also after pass out. So I think that I have to need to improve. So I began the study because I have 6 months time left and I have to whatever maybe the 6 months I have to do within that period of times. So time management is a very key factor for those who are in B-Pharms and also preparing for GPAT. And don't think that the B-Pharm and GPAT, those are very different kind of things. The approach are different, but the subjects are same. So don't hesitate how you approach that, like who kind of approach are there. Because in semesters, we have to prepare for the long questions types mostly. And for GPAT, there is also MCQs. So, but the similarity in between that the concepts will never change, whether in the paper of semester paper and in the GPAT paper. So people, I see that they prepare for the simultaneously. So it is a quite advantage, I must say, to the semester preparation. Those who prepare for the semester thoroughly, they get a lot of time to read the books properly and simultaneously practice that same chapters MCQ for the GPATs also. So it will, you don't feel any kind of burden and you will enjoy the things.
Yeah, because that is the most important while doing your semester study. Please study in the detail and simultaneously try to solve the MCQs of same chapter. That is the most important. So you don't have to prepare separately for GPAT. You just prepare your semester very well and practice the whatever is important for GPAT at that time.
Yes, sir. And I must have last. I want to add one point.
Yes.
And it before two to two before 2 to 3 months, specially dedicated for the GPAT preparations.
Yes. And Satyaranjan, please tell our student, what is the basic difference between GPAT and NIPER? So, whether you have to prepare separately for NIPER or preparation of GPAT will cover at least 70-80% of NIPER. Means, बहुत सारे बच्चों को question होता है कि sir मैंने GPAT किया, NIPER का क्या? NIPER GPAT में क्या difference क्या है basically? और आपका preparation कैसे होना चाहिए? ये दोनों में साथ में ही prepare कर सकते हो?
The main difference between the patterns, first thing. In NIPER, you will get 200 questions and in 2 hours. But in the cases of the GPAT, it is around 125 questions in 3 hours. So first thing is the time factor. So in the NIPER, you will get very less time comparative to GPAT. And whatever in the 2020 was, the paper of NIPER was very tough comparative to the GPAT paper. So and nowadays, I recollect or collect from the juniors also, this year paper was very easy. So you may expect in your family also that, and patterns for GPAT also gradually easy in day by day also. And NTA, they're focusing on the fundamentals and basics kind of things. So be ready with that. And the main difference in between the preparation strategy for NIPER apart from the GPAT, both are same thing, but the main difference is that some says that GPAT needs very depth understanding of the concepts, but NIPER is totally unpredictable. You can't predict the questions because it is very variation. Largely, you can see that papers are some suggest chemistry based, some suggest the questions are from non-pharma background. So you have to be ready with that. So specifically, be ready with the organics analysis. Specific to NIPER, I'm pointing out organics, analysis, pharmacology, and the recent trends in the farm news, and race all the preparations what you covered in the GPAT that will surpass your preparations, and the time management and practicing lot of MCQs will help you in NIPER comparative to GPAT, because you have to increase your speed with accuracy in the paper. But in the cases of GPAT, you get enough time to revise 2 times, 3 times, 4 times, whatever you can. But in the NIPER, it is very difficult to revise single time also.
Satyaranjan, thank you very much for guiding our student. और मुझे ये बताइए कि क्या difference क्या होता है, मतलब जब तक आप GPAT clear नहीं करते हो, GPAT qualify नहीं करते हो, जब तक आप NIPER qualify नहीं करते हो, उसके पहले की life और उसके बाद की life, इसमें क्या difference है, मतलब लोग आपको किस तरह से देखते हैं, मतलब जब आप जब सिर्फ आप स्टूडेंट थे, आपको GPAT नहीं किया था, आपने NIPER नहीं क्वालिफाई किया था, उस टाइम पे आपसे बात करने का तरीका क्या था लोगों का? और अभी जब GPAT आपका हो गया है, NIPER में अच्छा रैंक आ गया, ऑल इंडिया रैंक 8, इट इज़ नॉट अ स्मॉल थिंग, ऑल इंडिया रैंक इट इज़ वेरी गुड थिंग, एंड आपको मोहाली में कौन सा भी सब्जेक्ट मिल सकता था आपको जो चाहिए वो, ठीक है? तो डिफरेंस क्या आता है फिर जब GPAT क्वालिफाई नहीं करते हो, NIPER क्वालिफाई नहीं करते हो, और GPAT क्वालिफाई करते हो, NIPER क्वालिफाई करते हो अच्छे से रैंक से, तो उसके बाद में जो डिफरेंस आता है जो बिहेवियर में लोगों के,
दैट यू विल इम्प्रूव योर सेल्फ इन द फील्ड ऑफ फार्म नॉलेज. सो यू विल बिफोर cracking GPAT, we all are same, but after cracking we make some differences, GPAT and NIPER. So and it also boost your some kind of confidence level in yourself, so you can betterly prosper in the field of farm field, and innovation thrives to you to doing some new kind of things in pharma field. So and you also get some clarity, and yes, the people perspective is that, like those who are your friends, and regarding they will also try to suggest something during your GPAT time also. Try to gather a lot of things from themselves also while preparing, from teachers also, whatever may be the suggestions is comes, always try to be ready for that, be preparing, and whatever will be think that it will be going, if I prepare for that way, that will be better, I can reach and my goal also. So obey to all, and after life of GPAT and NIPER, it's quite relaxing compared to before to that. So you will also get some
Satyaranjan, what is your future goals and what is your targets, future targets? Okay, future plan kya hai, kya karna hai baad mein? Ab jaise aap MS kar rahe ho pharmaceutics se, Mohali se, पास आउट होंगे तो आपको मतलब किस फील्ड में जाना है, रिसर्च में जाना है या फिर आप जॉब करेंगे?
Till now I'm in confusion in between jobs and PhD, but still some kind of 40, 60 and 60 will be for PhDs. So I think that I will be go for the PhD, and in India also I'm trying. So for Naipa specifically.
Sataranjan.
Now for Naipa, till now it's PhD.
Sataranjan, thank you very much. And last question to you. What is role of fundamental pharmacy in your JPAT Naipa success? So JPAT Naipa के लिए आपको fundamental pharmacy से क्या help, कैसा role आप कहाँ पे देखते हो?
Yes, from beginning I also that I started my journey from fundamental pharmacy. It's frankly true. I casually joined the group as like that. But sir was consistent during posting the questions all days and we take their explanations also. So at that time we take it carelessly. But it matters when I appear for the GPAT. So we like fundamental pharmacy plays a very crucial role. And some of the questions are from the fundamental. And also at the time also took some test series also for practicing from fundamental pharmacy. That was also good. You can practice anywhere from else. But what main thing is the practice and learning the things. Whichever platform you learn, that is the main thing. So I think that from I partially prepared from the fundamental pharmacy platform.
How is your sister? How is she doing?
Yes, sir. She is preparing for the GPAT examination. So, hope so. What she will do.
So, what do you think about that fundamental pharmacy, fundamentals of GPAT book? How is it is and whether it is useful or not?
So I whenever I say the first time, the book was good and some of the remodeling or re-editions will be. Incoming will be, I think that will be in subsequent editions. So it's a good book, sir, because the books are always the precious things to in pharma professionals and any other thing. Books is very important for life. So whatever the books must be read by the students and whatever the concept and whatever the things we get from the books. So it must be implicated through the work. So books are very precious things. So fundamental pharmacy, I saw that the books is also very comprising of the subjects and whatever the parts are was not covered, I think that subsequent editions will cover the things. So it's a good book. And for last moment preparations, I will suggest that the textbook is always good, but the books in fundamental pharmacy that is also in depth also. And in last moment preparation, it helps, I think that in all the participants we could in tabular forms and charts form. And you have also less time to revise the textbooks. So go through that, the book is good.
Thank you very much, Sataranjan. I know your life is very busy. You are doing MS and you have a lot of things to do. You might be very busy. And in that busy condition, you have given us your precious times. So thank you very much for joining us and guiding our student. I know definitely student will take something positive from this session. And they will get idea about how to prepare, what is to be focused, what is to be not to be focused, and how to prepare. And they will get positive energy from this session. Thank you very much, Sataranjan, for joining us. And lastly, best of luck for your future. आप जो भी आपके life में करना चाहोगे उसके लिए best of luck आपसे. और भगवान करे आपको जो भी आपको चाहिए, जो भी आपका desire है, जो भी आपका aim है, achievement, वो आपको मिल जाए और life में आप जो भी करना चाहते हैं उसमें आपको सक्सेस मिले. थैंक यू. ऑलवेज वेल विशिंग.
थैंक यू सर. सर वन लास्ट मैसेज टू द जूनियर्स. ऑलवेज पार्ट ऑफ थिंग दैट स्टडी विल बी द कंटिन्यू बट ट्राई टू मोटिवेट योरसेल्फ. योर स्टेट अप एंड डिसाइड्स ऑल द थिंग्स इन द पेपर इन नाइपर. सो डोंट डिस्टर्ब एट दैट टाइम एंड प्रिपेरिंग एंड ऑलवेज ट्राई टू मोटिवेट डे बाई डे एंड ग्रेजुअली इंक्रीजिंग योर सेल्फ कॉन्फिडेंस. Sometimes what happens in rural areas and other areas, people don't get the enough chances to explore their things in the pharma field. They join. Now the world is very small and corona, it did a lot of us in digital era. So try to learn lot of things and improve day by day. And whatever the materials you have, so be thorough with that also. And it will be enough for the GPAT preparation. Whatever you read the BPharm. And whatever the suggestion was given by your teachers during your BPharm, just apply that and that is enough. And state of mind is the matter the most what I learned from the past year, because during my GPAT preparations also, I was a little nervous. It was ready with that. How do you respond to that things and how you conquer that things? So this is the main thing we have to maintain from GPAT to the NIPA. The cycle is lengthy. Some are prepared from second year, some are prepared from third year. somewhere prepared from 4 years. So no issue with it. But the thing is that how you manage your times and in wise way and in proper directions and proper state of mind. And definitely will get the success if you go through it to fundamental pharmacy. And Sachin sir, again to all the teams of sir and
for your information, Satranjan, I don't have any team. I am only single person. I used to manage each and everything by one hand.
Yes sir.
Don't have a team, but I am not less than a team. Thank you very much, Satranjan, yes, for guiding our students. And definitely student will get help on this session. I wish you best luck for your future. Whatever you want, you will get it.